ganglion is the same thing as a cyst. So to say ganglion cyst is like saying cyst, cyst. There's a tendency for people to do this, but it really means they're one and the same, just like broken bone and fracture mean the same thing. Cysts are very common in a few parts of the body. The most common place is probably the top of the wrist, or we call it the dorsum of the wrist, coming out between the two main bones of the wrist, the scaphoid and the lunate. And the second most common place is probably on the palmar side of the wrist, next to the flexor tendon, the main one called the FCR tendon. And a third place, the one that's most uncomfortable for a person, is when it occurs right at the base of the finger, at the crease, and that's called a flexor retinacular cyst. And those tend to hurt every time a person grips something. As far as we can discern, these are degenerative. Now, that seems a little weird because a high percentage of on the top of the wrist, the bottom of the wrist, they can occur elsewhere, like on the foot, but the point is that the high percentage of them are in kids. Turns out the ones that occur in kids between, you know, up to about 12 years old, well, they'll just resolve on their own. So we don't make much of an emphasis on taking them out unless they persist or become just really unsightly. And on the top of the wrist, there's a nerve there called the posterointerosseous nerve, which can be impinged upon or pressed upon by the cyst and can make it painful. So that's probably the main cause of pain when they occur on the top of the wrist. And if it doesn't pop on its own, it becomes unsightly, they can be removed. They tend to be removed more in adults than in kids because the tendency to naturally go away on their own in kids. I can't remember the exact percentage, but there's certainly no hurry to substitute a scar for a lump. In this case, an x-ray and a careful exam will tell us if there's anything else that needs to be treated. Though retinacular cysts in the base of the finger generally need to be cut out. If we poke them with a needle, if we're lucky enough to pop it, it will typically reaccumulate the gooey fluid. The fluid is basically the products of degeneration of the local band covering the tendon. And as on the top of the wrist, there's degeneration of part of a ligament there. And taking it out doesn't render the wrist or the finger unstable, but gets rid of the growth, which does not typically recur. It'd be pretty unusual for them to recur. A very common area of a cyst that are very noticeable and tends to be in older age people, probably over the age of 50 in most cases, are what are known as mucus cysts, will occur on the top, to usually not directly over the center, but over one side or the other, of the end joint of the fingers, known as the DIP joint. And they're important to take care of because if they rupture and then expose the joint to contamination, because they communicate with an arthritic joint, and then you can get a terrible infection, end up in the hospital, and even having the joint fused. And some people come in after it's ruptured a few times, and luckily they haven't gotten an infection. But once we remove the prominent bone that's developed from the arthritis there and take the cyst out at the same time, they do not typically recur, plus it makes the finger look nicer. The side effect to having the mucus cyst is that, and sometimes what the cause of the person to even come in to be seen is it makes the fingernail itself look ugly. It'll give a deep pit in the nail, and that can make it rough, and so their nail will catch on things, etc. It takes about 4 months to grow an entirely new nail, so about 4 months from the time that the cyst is removed, in that case, the nail will then regain its normal appearance.